Amen. Look at your neighbor and tell them of the thankfulness of God. The thankfulness of God.
Oh,
He set me free. Hymn number 235. Amen. Ain't you glad that Jesus set you free this morning?
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. I was who the Son set free. He's free indeed. Amen. Hymn number 235.
Thank you.
Bibles with you today. Raise them up. Let me see. If you don't have a Bible, we want to give you one. You know why? I could be a false prophet up here. I could be preaching out of a comic book. So if you don't have a Bible, raise your hand and we'll get you one, okay? You need a Bible. All right. If you have your Bibles, turn to the book of Psalms as he plays this song. Listen to the words of it. Something I've never done before. If you have a pencil or paper, you might want to get it out if you want to. If you don't want to, you don't have to. I always tell people to maybe bring a little pad and pen with you and let it be a blessing to you. Somebody say amen. All right, let's just go to Psalms chapter 69. Did anybody get it? Psalm 69, verse number 30.
Psalm 69 of verse 30. I ask everybody if they would to stand in the presence of God as we read this together. Amen. When Jesus was in the temple, he had people to stand to read God's word. Can you stand, please? Honoring God's word. How many thank God for God's word?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Psalm 69 and verse number 30. You'll find these words there. I will praise the name of God with a song, and I will magnify him with what?
Thanksgiving.
I can't hear you.
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. Absolutely right. If I had to use for the title of my message today, it would be the thankfulness of God. Matter of fact, Rhonda, in her Bible study last week, she got almost all of my message, and I thought, wow, this is really confirmation here. And I just pray that you'll be blessed as we go through the Word of God this morning. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord. I thank you so much, Lord, for new people will come in, and God, that we can love on them and show them the way of the Lord. And I pray, Father, if there's someone here today that's lost without God, maybe they're backslid, Lord. Somebody might be backslid. And I just pray, Father, today will be the day that you just call them home, Lord. And they'll be called, amen, to your purpose, Lord, that you'll just call them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You said, I didn't call the righteous, but I've called the sinners to repentance. And Lord, give me words of wisdom. Give me words of knowledge. Without you, God, I could not walk without you holding my hand. And I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And everybody say it.
Amen.
Before you sit down, look at somebody and tell them I love you and a thing you can do about it. For many people, Thanksgiving is just a holiday together with their family and friends, eat turkey, and watch football. But what does the Bible say about giving thanks? And as I looked all these things up, I'm thinking, Lord, when am I going to stop for all these thankfulness that you give us in Scripture? What does the Bible say about it? Through the Scriptures, we'll see verse after verse highlighting the importance role of thankfulness has in Christians' life. Despite of the circumstances, as believers, we shouldn't limit giving thanks to a single day. It should be such a habit that naturally flows out of us every day. We should be so full of appreciation for everything God has done for us. You should have shouted right there. That we just don't keep silence about it. The following scriptures that I'm going to read with you today will help you begin to be grateful and remind us to be motivated to live in gratitude. Incorporate these in your daily devotion time and share them with your family and friends as you gather around the Thanksgiving table. I got 10 scriptures I want to give you that the Lord had gave to me to give to you. And the first one is in 1 Chronicles 16 and 8 says, give thanks unto the Lord, call on his name, and make known his deeds among the people. Number two. It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises to thy name, O Most High, to show forth thy loving kindness in the morning and thy faithfulness every night. At Psalms 92, 1 through 2. Number 3. Psalms 104 says, enter in his gates with thanksgiving and in his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. That's why we come to the sanctuary. That's why we come to church. Amen. To come in here, amen, and to bless his name, to worship him in spirit and in truth. If you believe that, say amen.
Amen.
We're not here, amen, today to put on a show or to see how pretty we look. We're coming here to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ that can set you free. Psalms, number 4. Psalms 103, I love this, 1 through 2. Now if you want the notes of this, I'll be glad to give it to you after the service. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. Hasn't the Lord been good to you, church? Think about all the benefits that we have. Think about all the things that He's did for us today. Amen. Number five, Psalms 136 and verse 1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. I said, for He is good.
Amen.
If you believe God's good, say amen.
Amen.
He's good, folks. He's been good to you. He's good. For His mercy endures forever. Verse number six. Ephesians 5 and 20. I might be going a little bit fast for you. But like I said, if you need the notes, let me know. Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Number seven. Colossians 3 and 17. Colossians 3, 17. You'll find these words in there. And whatsoever you do in word and deed, you do it all in the name of Pastor David Bell. No, they don't say that, does it? He said, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving Him thanks to God and the Father by Him. Anything you want to do for God, you want to do it for His. Amen? Do it for Him. I never forget it. There's a guy at our church at the time, we had a lot of lawn to mow, and he kind of got an attitude because he was always having to mow the grass all the time. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, there was a voice, he said, that came to him. And he said he heard this voice. Who are you doing this for? Are you doing it for the people? Or are you doing it for God? And he just kept on mowing. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
We do it for God. For God be the glory.
Yeah.
Amen. For God be the glory. Yeah. You're not doing it for the pastor. You're not doing it for anything. The people that does the cleaning here. People that does jobs. A maintenance crew. And all these things. You do it for the glory of God.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. I heard Tammy out there. Number eight. 1 Thessalonians 5. And 18 says, and everything give thanks. I mean everything.
Amen.
For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Number 9. 1 Timothy 4. This is going to make a lot of people mad. 1 Timothy 4. 4 through 5. Watch this. For every creature of God is good. Now this is what the Bible said. Every creature of God is good. And nothing to be refused. Watch this. Here's the key. If it is done and received with thanksgiving. For it is sanctified by the word of God and prayer. Before you cut in that turkey, before you put your lips to it. You ought to thank God for that turkey.
Amen.
And I'll tell you another thing. Now, a lot of people won't do that. This is your own business. That's up to you. That's between you and God. He said, every creature is good. And Thanksgiving, when we get around the table, one thing I'm looking for, I like turkey, don't get me wrong. But one thing I'm looking for on that on my table is some good old ham. Somebody say amen. Some people won't even touch it. Oh, you can't eat it. I'm here to tell you can eat it. As long as you pray over and sanctify it through the word of God in prayer. Give me a piece of ham and I promise you I'll eat it.
Amen.
I love you guys and I appreciate you. That's what it says. I didn't read that out of the comic book. That's what your Bible says. Because I like fried chicken too. Number 10, I told you this would be quick. Number 10 is Philippians. Now, I was kind of hoping David Anglin would be here today. He wasn't here today. But me and my wife went and visited his mother. It's in a nursing home in Fort Wayne. I told my wife, I said, let's go. We're going to go see her. And so we went to the nursing home and they said she's in room, I can't remember what the number was. And my wife said, honey, there she is. I said, no, that's not her. I just kept on walking. She said, honey, that's her. And then she looks so changed that she ended up with a bed sore, and it's so bad that you can put your fist right through it. And as I prayed with her, my heart just broke. As I prayed for her, arms, it just feel, it's like you're touching bone. She's lost so much weight, I couldn't even recognize her. We just pleaded the blood of Jesus Christ over her and prayed for her. And I asked her, I said, she didn't even know this, and I was trying to get this thing prepared here for Thanksgiving. And I just asked her, I said, honey, I said, what's your favorite verse? And this is what she gave me. And I put it at number 10. You'll find these words spinned there. And if you can listen to me, Nancy, if you got power to touch that button, and I always give her the message that I preach, and I hope she can be able to hear this. I'm going to dedicate this verse to her. Philippians 4, 6 through 7. One of the greatest scriptures here. Philippians 4, 6 through 7. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to David Bell. No, it says to God. Let your request be made known to God. Bring your request. Whatever your request is, let it be known by God. Amen. And God can work out whatever problem you have this morning. Maybe you're so far away from God, but God wants you to bring you home. And maybe you're looking for that special church. I'm here to tell you, this is a special church. This is anointed by God, and we'll love you so much that you'll just have to love us and come back. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
If you appreciate our visitors today, give them a hand clap of praise. Yes. When a visitor walks through those doors, they're either going to say, I'm dying, coming back, or I'm going to come back next week. There are people here today as walk through this room, walk through the sanctuary, feel the presence of God, feel the word of God, and said, my God, this is our church. And they're here today. Give God a hand clap of praise for this house. Oh, I'm not done. And the peace of God. How many glad for the peace of God in your life? He said he'll keep you in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. Praise God. The peace of God which passeth all understanding. Watch this. Shall keep your hearts and your minds through Jesus Christ.
Yes, amen.
My God. So many people are so depressed, won't even come out of their room. Some of them so depressed, all they want to do is commit suicide. I'm telling you, that's of the devil out of hell.
Come on.
Jesus Christ loves you. There's no time for suicide. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost. And the Bible said if any man will destroy this body, he will destroy you. Amen. If you're depressed today or you're lonely, you're going through a hard time, this is what the church is for. For us to pray for you. Somebody say amen. We'll anoint you and pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. And the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. That's what your Bible says. The Bible said you shall lay his hands on the sick and they shall recover. I don't care what kind of condition you got. God can heal anything. If you believe that, say amen. He can heal anything. So keep your minds through Jesus Christ. Keep your minds focused. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Keep your focus in this. This is what will bring you through is the word of God. That's why a lot of people don't want to read it. Because they want to do what they want to do. You know, I'm not going to hold you long. That looks like I said. That was from the Lord. I'm going to tell you, this is a speaker quote book. This is pastors that sat down and wrote things in here to encourage you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So I just want to read something to you. Is that all right? You mind if I read it? How many of you give me 5 more minutes? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Hallelujah. All right. I'm about done, folks. All right, this is what was going across me. Thankfulness. I mean, as I looked at the Lord, gave me that title, and I look in here and it says thankfulness. I say, thank you, Lord. I am a Christian, but sometimes I forget to thank God for the things that hasn't happened. Not this year. I'm grateful for the accident that I wasn't involved in. I mean, thank God for those accidents that you're not involved in. When me and my wife went to Florida last year, a couple of years ago, we was on that interstate. 4 lanes. This is the gospel, if I have to tell you. One lady moved from her lane, and she was coming right towards us. If I wouldn't have moved my car, we would have had a pileup. So what I did is, when I saw her, I moved over to the left side. And guess what? There was not another car there. Why? Because the angel of the Lord was watching over us. Amen. Yeah. So we ought to be thankful for those days that we was involved in an accident. An illness that never developed. In times, about an illness that never is recovered. I was thinking about the time that they called me back into the doctor's office. I had a test. I have a trunk foot in my leg, and when I tripped over a little concrete, and when I did, I fell on my chest and ended up in the hospital. It's been a few years ago. They had to take x-rays on my chest. I'm going to tell you how God is. They called me on the phone and says, you know, you got a shallow in your chest area. We don't know what it is, but there's a spot there. And we need to see. Well, I can't remember what date it was when I was supposed to come, if I was supposed to come right then or not. But then I got the call back. And the nurse said, just forget it. It was just a shallow. It ain't nothing serious. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
See, that's how God is. Amen. Thank God for those times that it could have been bad, but it ended up being good. Amen. I could have been mugged. You know, how many times that God has kept you safe from being mugged or killed? I'm here to tell you I was. I used to drive a semi, like a flatbedded truck, 10-speed, and I hauled steel. Maybe I've told this before, I'm going to tell it again. I was hauling steel, minding my own business, came to a stoplight in South Bend, Indiana, and these black people came up. And they held a 45 through the window to my brain. And I said, oh, Lord, I'm going to die right here. And the guy pulled his gun back, and they began to laugh and went on. God spared my life. God has spared my life a lot of times, folks. He spared my life from being killed or mugged. You ever seen that? There's a movie on. And these people are going to. They were going to mug this lady. And she goes, Jesus! And those people just took off.
Yeah.
I forgot what movie it was, but it was good. So glad I haven't been mugged. I wasn't. I'm thankful. Watch this. I'm thankful my house didn't burn down when I left the iron on for 5 hours. I'm thankful that when we left the garage door open all night, nothing was taken. Sometimes I forget to thank God for the electricity. Should have shouted right there. How many times have you ever been in your house and electricity go off? And buddy, you're out with water, you can't see, you got to get a light, a fleshlight and all kinds of candles as they see. Some of us have been out of electricity for 3 or 4 days. But when that electricity come on, won't you, ain't you glad for electricity? Somebody say. Sometimes we forget to thank God for all these things. But this Thanksgiving, I will make a point of it. I am also thankful for the indoor plumbing.
Amen.
The necessities. Ever since my daughter nearly sheared her finger off in the door, bathroom door, I'm grateful and thankful she wasn't hurt. I am thankful for my daughters, my sons. How many thank God for your daughter and sons?
Amen.
Ain't you glad you're saved today and in church with you today? If you believe that, give God a hand clap of praise for your daughters and your sons. You're in the church now. I got two daughters. I never had a boy. I might have had a boy. We lost our first one. And no doubt it probably was a boy. To this day, I don't know. And they asked me if I wanted to go back and see it. And I said, no. One day I'll see it in heaven. My pastor, the pastor over here in the early 70s, went with us to the hospital. God spoke to that pastor, and he said, David, don't you worry. God spoke to me, and by the time next year, your wife will have a child. And that's when Angie was born. Give God a hand clap of praise. It devastated me, but God had a plan. Amen. So thank God for your daughters. Psalms 101. Amen. Psalms 100. Enter into his gates. Into his gates on Thanksgiving. I am glad I have someone to thank this year. And that someone is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
One little clipping, I'll let you go. It's touched my heart. Prayer of heart, the prayer of heart of thanksgiving. Lord, forgive me for neglecting to give you thanks and praise each day. Forgive me for whining and complaining instead of being grateful. You should have shouted right there. Teach me to pray continually, to be joyful always, and to give thanks in all my circumstances. Help me to start afresh and make a daily praise and thanksgiving a habit. I want to begin by thanking you. You are your love and your grace, and for all the times you've already blessed me. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So this year, thank him for what he has done. And I know that we do, but don't focus on all these other things. Just give God the praise that is due to his name.
Yeah.
Give him praise. But you know, the Bible said that everything that you've got breath, he said, praise the Lord.
Yeah.
That's what the Bible said. So I'm going to praise him. I'm going to praise him for the things that he has done in my life. And we had that talk on Wednesday night. What are we thankful for? A lot of us stood up and said what we're thankful for. And like I said, if we would just, each of us, we did this several years ago in a Bible study that we had the chalkboard, and we just sat around us men and asked, what are we thankful for? We filled that whole chalkboard up. And we still have things to do. So be thankful. You know, be thankful that, you know, today that you're here, and if you're lost without God, God made it a way that you could come and give your heart and life to Jesus Christ. You know what the Bible says? The Bible says today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow. You have no promise of tomorrow.
That's right.
Today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow. You have no promise of tomorrow. The Bible said we're like a vapor. We could be here today and gone tomorrow. What about your life today? If your heart would stop beating right where you sit, would you go to heaven? You say, oh, Pastor, that will never happen. I'm here to tell you, one of my preachers I preached for in Hartford, Michigan, had a heart attack right in the front row as he was sitting down. Died. Went on to be with the Lord. There was another one in Constantine, Michigan. It's right across the street. It's right across the road there. about 4 miles down the road. Got up, went to get in his car, fell over with a heart attack and died right in the church. Folks, this is serious. I want to tell you, Jesus loves you. We're here for a reason. We want to win the loss at any cost. And if you're here today and God's been moving on your heart, I invite you in Jesus' name to come to find the greatest friend in the world. A friend that will never leave you nor forsake you. And your friends have. Mom and Dad has. Oh yeah, they have. On Thanksgiving Day, their parents and kids fighting like dogs and cats can't get along. What about your heart? Let's all stand, and we're going to give you an opportunity. If you don't know how to be saved, we'll sure lead you to God. Jesus loves you. God bless you. Take these verses back home and look them up, and it'll be a blessing to you. If you want a copy of this sermon, we'll be glad to give you a copy. Thank you for coming. This altar is open. Maybe you have a loved one that's lost without God that you want to pray for, and God will save them. Jesus, we thank you for your word. I've did my part, Lord, so they have to do theirs. If I could save them, God, I'd save everybody, but I can't save nobody. The Bible said if any man come any other way but through that door, he's a thief and a robber. I believe that's in John chapter 10 and verse 1. Verse 10 in that same chapter. The thief's coming to kill, to steal, and destroy. But he said, I've come that you might have life and to have it more abundantly. I pray, Father, that there's just one here today who will come to this altar and be saved. I thank you for it. If they don't, Lord, I pray in the future they'll come to know you, Lord. He said, I've come to seek and to save that which is lost. God's not lost, you're lost. I just pray, Heavenly Father, that you bless me in Jesus' name. Bless this congregation. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As he plays a song, you want to come and gather around the altar, you're welcome to it. I'll meet you here. Give your heart to God and just change your life. This altar's open. Amen. Praise God. Come on, sis. That's right. You're obeying God. You're obeying God. Bless you. Bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. clap for a soul to save. Absolutely. 6 o'clock tonight. Come back and support Associate Pastor. Amen. Amen tonight. Please come back and be with us tonight if you can. Amen. 6 o'clock. Raise your hand. Repeat after me. What I say unto one.
What I say unto one.
What I say unto all.
What I say unto all.
You better watch.